Hey guys, this is Microphone Conquer Chemistry. In today's video, we'll be taking a look at how to read and label single-step energy profile diagrams. Energy profile diagram shows how the energy changes as the reaction progresses. Usually the label for the y-axis will be potential energy or heat energy, and the label for the x-axis is generally reaction coordinate, reaction progression, or time. We're going to label the following on this energy profile diagram. So first label the reactants. The reactants is the starting line. So here are the reactants. You can see the reactants has a potential energy of about 40 kilojoules per mole. The products will be the ending line. You can see that products will have a potential energy of about 10 kilojoules per mole. The activated complex and transition state, these are interchangeable and they will be found at the very peak of the curve. So this is where the activated complex and transition state is, and that has a potential energy roughly about 57 kilojoules per mole. The delta H, or the change enthalpy of the reaction, is just the amount, the energy of the products minus the energy of the reactants, and that's reflected by the gap between the reactants and products. So this will be 10 minus 40, which will be negative 30 kilojoules per mole, making this a exothermic reaction. The change enthalpy for the reverse reaction, so this is asking what the delta H would be if instead you went from right to left instead of left to right. It will still be the difference between the reactant and products, but then this time it will be 40 minus 10, so it'll be 30 kilojoules per mole. Because if it's in the reverse direction, then this will be the product and that will be the reactants. So you can see that the delta H of the forward reaction and reverse reaction have the same magnitude, but just different signs. The activation energy is the amount of energy it takes to start the reaction. So you can just think of it's the hill that you have to get over to go from the reactants to the product side. And that would just be the difference between the starting point and the very peak of the hill. And so that would be 57. Minus 40, so the activation energy would be 27 kilojoules per mole. The activation energy of the reverse reaction is the difference between the right-hand side and the very peak. So that'll be this difference. This is the activation energy of the reverse direction. Oops, I forgot to label the activation energy here. So that would be 67 minus 10, or 57 minus 10. So that would be 47 kilojoules per mole. And next we have to draw how the energy profile diagram would look like if a catalyst was used. So a catalyst just speeds up the reaction by lowering the activation energy of the reaction, but it doesn't change the energy of the products or reactants. So the beginning line and the ending line will stay the same. And the only difference is that we're going to make the hump smaller. So this right here is the energy profile diagram for a exothermic reaction, because you can see that the energy was going down. You can also see that the delta H was negative. The profile diagram for a endothermic reaction will look as such. You can see that the products have more energy than the reactants. You can also determine that's endothermic because you can see that the energy is going up as the reaction progresses. And there you have it. That's how you would label and read a single-step energy profile diagram.
If you want to learn how to ace chemistry, if you want to learn what's the best way to study for this class, if you want to learn some neat tricks and tips to take into your exam and do better on them, then you should head over to my website and get this free guide, 12 Secrets to Acing Chemistry. You can head over to www.conquerchemistry.com/chemsecrets. I'm going to include a link in the description below. Check it out. I think it's really going to help you, and you're going to like it. Until next time, keep working hard and continue the good work.